हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन आर लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अप टू ऑटोमेटेड व्हीकल ऑपरेशन इन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ स्मार्ट सिटी सब्जेक्ट। टुडे वी डिस्कस ऑन अ कोलिजन अवॉइडेंस। सो हियर वी यूज द डिफरेंट मेथोडोलॉजी टू अवॉइड द कोलिजन। सो यूज रडार, लेजर, कैमरा एंड जीपीएस सिस्टम टू अवॉइड एनी कोलिजन। And here one by one we discuss on it. So first we discuss on a longitudinal. So head-on collision warning and rear end collision warning and adaptive cruise control and autonomous energy braking. So these are the longitudinal collision avoidance. And here in a head-on collision warning. So when any vehicle travel in on road and at that time in front side any obstruction is there, and here warning is given to driver by any lights or any sound. So it's called a head on collision warning. And similarly in a when any driver park the vehicle and in a back side in a reverse direction when any vehicle travel, so at that time collision warning is given to the driver by using the any lights or any sound. Here these are the main important to avoid the collision. So like see this figure. So from the figure you exactly seen that. So here one vehicle is travel, and here in front of the vehicle another vehicle is travel. So here warning plus brake assistant, so is a dangerous collision. But here signal is provided. Here in a second stage, you in a first stage you exactly seen that distance between the two vehicle is decreased. So here compulsory warning and automatic brake signal is required. And extremely high dangerous collisions like a distance is very little bit. So here warning of the strong automatic brake is compulsory required. So here see this brake and also sound of the warning sound is listened by the driver. So these are the collision warning. Second is lateral. So here lateral is see this lane departure warning. So if you change the lane, so this type of the signal or light is turn on and warning sign is given to driver, so is known as a lateral warning. Next is a blind spot situation. So in a when any person drive a car, so look like this. So at that time some of the blind spot is there. So in a blind spot, like look like this, both the side are blind spots. So two vehicle is travel. So but driver cannot see this true vehicle, so he is known as a blind spot. So blind spot is easily given the direct guidance to the driver as a warning sign, is known as a blind spot situation. Now next is a intersection collision. So like here in a crossroad, so there are the zebra crossing is there, this four zebra crossing is there, and all the vehicles are not collision in a crossroad. So here intersection collision avoidance signal is required. So if any vehicle is very near to another vehicle. Next is a pre-crash resistance deployment. So here hold the people in their seat and prevent from the being injury during the collision. So here seat belt is compulsory required in a car. So if any person is not wear a seat belt and suddenly brake is applied by the driver, so here collision is and injuries created, and automatic seat belt is also most important in a car, and airbag is most important at the time of the accident. So in airbag, thin nylon fabric material is there and inflate on impact. So like airbag is to save the life of the people during the collision. So see this figure, in this photograph you exactly seen that seat belt is wear. If seat belt is not wear, so warning sign is given to driver to wear a seat belt. And seat belt save the life during the suddenly collision or suddenly apply the brake and save the life of the driver. And next is the safety readiness. Safety readiness. So provide information on vehicle condition. So like any damages inside of the machinery parts. So here signal is given. Then after coolant level, so all the level of the like a petrol or diesel or gas, etc., fuel level and also coolant level is seen on a screen or on a to the driver. And engine oil and brake fluid level also indicate on a screen. And tire pressure is also seen on a screen. So in which tire pressure is decrease or increase, so this is most important thing. And malfunction warning and seat belt warning, like a seat belt warning, you all of you seen that in a seat belt warning. So seat belt, if any person is not wear a seat belt, so directly warning sign, directly sound is listened to the driver and another person. And if door opening warning signal, so here if car door is open, so car is not start or gear is not working, so this type of the warning is in a safety purpose. Now over speed warning. So over speed warning, like if your car is moving from 80 kilometer per hours or more than 80 kilometer per hours or 100 kilometer per hours, so at that time warning sign or a warning sound is listened by the all the persons who travel in a car. And advanced public transportation system, so is short form is APTS, advanced public transportation system. Now in this public transportation system, public transport management, then after provide a real time analysis on a vehicle and facility. So here first point is a public transport management, like regular and routine transportation system is provided, like very well prepare a schedule. And then after, as per the schedule, all the buses or any train or tramway etc. are travel on time on schedule. So it's one type of the public transportation management. Then after, second point is a provide a real time analysis on of a vehicle and facilities. So on a bus stand, passenger easily seen the travel time and also location of the bus and how many time is taken to arrive at the stand. All these things are seen on a screen on a platform. And GPS based automatic vehicle location. So automatic vehicle location is vehicle location is all of you listen in a bus or look like example like BRTS. In a BRTS, each and every stand name is listened by the passenger. So identify deviation from the schedule and assure the transfer connection between the vehicle and modes. And computer aided dispatch, its short form is a CAD. And automatic passenger counting. So when any passenger is seated on a When any passenger is seated in a bus or a tramway or any metro train, so at that time passenger is directly count and how many passenger is travel in a one time, so it's easily and automatically counted, and real time and web passenger information is display on a screen. And traffic signal priority integration is also given, and next stop automated vehicle announcement is given, like in a BRTS, next stop automated vehicle announcement is done by the automatically announcement is given in a bus, and passenger is listen and then after ready for the comes out. Now next is see this bus is automatic, fully automatic bus. Now here some of the features is fixed, like passenger counting, then after infrared sensor and cameras technology. So here no any thief problem is there, and advanced reporting system is also fix in a bus. So these are the latest technology for preparing the bus. Next is the benefits of the using the this technology. So enhance operating efficiency and increase the service and reduce the commute time. So here traveling time, service is very well, and all these things, like if we compare these things with local travelers, so you exactly seen the difference between the using the technical things and non-technical things. So here we compare the BRTS and AMTS in Ahmedabad city, so exactly you differentiate between the two things. Now next is shared transportation management. So in a shared vehicle and a cost for journey and a hybrid private vehicle and a mass transit and a car and van pooling and share taxis and reduce the GHG emission. So these are the shared transportation management system. So in a shared transportation management system, you all of you know about the car pooling or sharing the car. So here sharing the vehicle or sharing the car is easy and comfort, but here some of the advantages and also some of the disadvantages is there. But here car pooling is save the one of the advantages is that save the fuel and also cost of the transportation is also be decreased. So these are the main benefits for sharing the transportation. So here we discuss the another topic is a commercial vehicle operation. So commercial vehicle operation is a enhanced safety and efficiency for a goods vehicle. So like any goods travel from the one place to another place, so here safety is compulsory required because it's a heavy transportation system. So here goods is very heavy and no any damages is done during the transportation and safely reach up to the end point or targeted point. Now next is a control to prevent the thieves of goods. So here locking system or automatic locking system is there to control or prevent the thieves, and monitoring movement on the vehicle. So if any vehicle is stopped at a particular place or any area, so automatically we see the location, so and monitor the movement of the vehicle. So like speed of the vehicle, road of the vehicle on which this vehicle is travel. So all these things are we monitor the movement of the vehicle, and automatic vehicle clearance at the check post, toll plaza. So here FASTag system is already introduced in our area. So by using this FASTag, वी क्लियर एंड ऑटोमेटिकली ऑटोमेटिकली व्हीकल क्लियरेंस एंड एट अ चेक पोस्ट विदाउट एनी ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. नाउ इमरजेंसी मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम, सो EMS. सो लाइक ड्यूरिंग द एक्सीडेंट्स टाइम और एनी मेडिकल इमरजेंसी इज देयर, सो इमरजेंसी मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम इज कंपल्सरी रिक्वायर्ड. सो इमरजेंसी नोटिफिकेशन एंड पर्सनल सिक्योरिटी इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग ड्यूरिंग द इमरजेंसी टाइम एंड नोटिफाई द अप्रोप्रिएट इमरजेंसी रिस्पॉन्सिस पर्सनल रिगार्डिंग द नीड्स फॉर असिस्टेंस इन केस ऑफ इमरजेंसी एंड ड्राइवर एंड पर्सनल सिक्योरिटी इज रिक्वायर्ड एट दैट टाइम एंड ऑटोमेटेड कॉलिजन नोटिफिकेशन इज रीच ऑन ऑफिस एंड वी सेव द लाइफ्स ऑफ द पीपल by using the emergency management system. So like see this photograph, if two car is collision, so from these two cars signal is directly reached on a main office. So there are the in this location there are accident is there and two cars is collision with each other. So this collision is easily solved and easily managed by the road person. Now in a emergency vehicle management, reduce the time notification and arrival at incident location and identify the most closest and appropriate response vehicle and route guidance and signal priority is and preemption. So these are the most important vehicle management system. So like see this photograph, from the photograph we exactly seen that if signal is close, so like signal is close and here red light is seen, so when any vehicle emergency vehicle is coming, so this signal is automatically done as a green signal and we clear the path or road. So this system is done automatically by using the sensor system. So this signal is transferred to the directly main crossroad lights and directly managed by the person and directly green light is on and we clear the routes of the crossroad for emergency purpose. Now electronic payment. So all of you know about the FASTag. So electronic financial transaction and electronic toll collection, FASTag is fixed on a car and when any car is reached, so automatically cut the amount from the Paytm and another tools of the transaction. And automatic after cutting the automatically amount, open the shutter for travel and automatically fare collection is a very good for it reduce or save the time of the person. Now next is a smart vehicle. So this smart vehicle is discussed in a next lecture. So this point we are discuss in the next lecture. We stop here our lecture. Thank you.